we'll have to go.
Dennis, do we have a binder rider or not?
Oh, yeah.
You actually ride the binder yourself?
Well, that's great to do. If somebody else wants to go, they can have a go.
No, we'll leave it to the professional, I think.
Professionals?
Well, professionals. Sorry. I would ask you spectators standing around not to do any swearing, because it'll all come out on the Christmas film that the club do. So, and not only that, but it's Sunday as well, isn't it, Den? How'd you get that lot home then, Den?
Oh, I took the trailer behind the car.
Yeah. So I suppose it's a case of going all over the place now to try and buy a bit of string. I'll tell you what, Dennis, I've got a bit bigger spanner if that one ain't big enough.
It is a bit much up. We've got a toolbox in the motor.
Yeah.
All right, but I think we're going to use many spanners when we start.
Sure. You've used this one this year, obviously. Yes.
Yeah, I'm bloody thing, Ed, it's too big.
Takes you back a bit, doesn't it, Jack?
Yeah.
three? Was it three church bells or something, I reckon, isn't it?
Three church bells on a Sunday, was it?
Ah, I think so, yeah. Yeah.
How's that? Good,
yeah.
Very good.
Hey? Good job. I say the old spanner doubles as hammer as well, then.
Yes.
It's a good job you carry a spare sail.
Yeah.
I think you got a couple in, yeah?
Yeah. That ain't really long enough. The bloody boat ain't long enough in that.
Away just like it used to be. There's a good gang, ain't there, Dan?
Yeah.
I'll tell you something else, I bet they're enjoying themselves.
Sounds a lot busy.
That's it. I see Annie Oakley's there with a gun.
That's why we've gone to this job.
All right, Tom.
But Ian's his tractor. With Father Dud driving and Robert riding the binder, here we are, what we're known as piking off now. No good, I can't keep up, I'm getting too old. So fetch your gun, somebody. Warning the big whale up and letting it down onto the other whales now. Up she goes. I think she's about back together and ready for road moving. The old Fordson and the old sun going down. The old girl's making a bit of smoke. But there we are, she's safe. Figure toils against the night sky. Well, the thrashing drums arrive, lads. We have a 500 weight of wheat we'd like you to grind. We need 20 pounds. Is that okay, sir?
That's right.
Right. Well, hold on. We've got to make sure that little mill's empty. Is the mill empty? Right. Start the clock. Okay, away she goes. Paul.
Okay, David.
Thank you very much.
There we are.
Thank you. Of the poundage we're up to?
7 pounds we've done so far.
We've done 7 pounds. Learn rest now. You all right, lads? We're up to about 16, 17 pounds, Claire. So I know, but the rules say we must mill 20. You leave your kit. Well. Timing's restarted at the bakery, it's 2:10. With Claire and Tony, our chefs today.
Good job, good night. Good job.
Officially two.
Officially, we've got to make two.
Yeah. What are the others for? Just general.
Just usually
filling the gaps.
Well, you see, we've got the oven going, and we've got the flour, so we might as well bake the loaves.
Turn us off a minute, Dave. I'm just working my fingers.
Put that in there, Harry.
Chickens don't want pre-eating.
Put it on there. Put it on there until you're ready again.
Well, I don't think that one looks very good. What else have we got?
They were the first ones that we did.
Yeah.
For the trial.
These are the trial loaves.
Yeah.
We'll do it for curbing.
Have you got a concrete breaker?
We have, we've got a concrete breaker. Then we'll do for curb edgings.
You're not stuck for the pan.
Does anyone likes rock cakes?
Very crusty.
Well, it's crusty if nothing else.
Oh, isn't that looking heavy?
Yeah? Nutty.
What else would you say, Tony?
Heavy.
Yeah. All right.
It's all right.
Yeah. Bit of butter.
It'll be eatable.
Yeah. Bit roughage.
Yeah.
I think Tony's a very brave man and deserves a clap. Come on, all together and not at all. It sounds like sympathy. Tony, fetch him out.
Thank you.
then, Tony. Well, this is the effort of the National Vintage Tractor and Engine Club. We've just come out of the oven. And Tony, our chef, and Claire. I don't know where Claire's gone. Where are you, Claire? Camera shy.
We need an efficient somebody.
Yep. Very nice.
It's edible. Very nice, you say.
Very nice indeed.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. You've made a will, I take it.
Absolutely. I've left all my debts to you, David.
And your ash is wanting tearing at any mix.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. That's what I call a company man to the finish.
Load out of the place.
This film engine line stands empty. The post's waiting to be taken up. Of straw left by the elevator. And the heap of chaff, waiting for the birds, the pigeons, or whatever to scratch amongst it. The ploughing, all finished, or nearly all finished. The distant food caravan, and the little Alice Chalmers and its trailer, waiting to be tidied up and put away. Unique elevator. Did its first day's work for probably 30 years yesterday. Gonna have a coat of paint before we put that away for the winter. And the headland unploughed, which our friend George will tidy up for us. A stack, isn't it?
Yes, I don't think it'll fall over.
No, I doubt it very much. almost a showpiece. Yeah, let's see if I can get in just a little closer and have a look at that skilled thatching work. Oh yeah, that's beautiful. I'll tell you what, Den, it's nice to see something like this nowadays, isn't it?
It won't get wet.
No, it won't get wet, you know, but I mean, you see these round bales strewed all over the place and they look so blinking untidy.
That's right.
And
straw that's burned, it might as well go on top and keep them dry.
Exactly. That's lovely, that's a real showpiece. And where we slipped back in time yesterday, for probably 20, 30 or even 40 years. It's all back to work again.